Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I will teach you how you can create your very own date stickers on the iPad directly in GoodNotes. Now you can use these stickers to date undated digital planners, but I will show you in this video how you can also use them to change the look of the existing dates on your dated planner. Okay, so let's get started. I'm going to open the planner that I will be using to keep my stickers, and this is GoodNotes. And actually this planner, let me show you the month, it comes dated already, but I will use the stickers that we make today to cover these dates. For now, I just want a blank page to start designing my stickers. So I'm going to select my pen tool here in GoodNotes, which is this icon over here, and then I'm going to go to the biggest size possible of ink. So if I tap on this size option, my slider is all the way to the right, and then you pick a color other than black so that you can see it on the back, or other than white if you're using a white sheet. And then I will just tap on any color, okay? And then all you have to do is draw a dot on the screen, but that's actually a little harder than it looks because it's easy to do more than a dot. I don't know if you can tell, but this is like two dots together, so I just want one dot. So you just try as many times as you need until you get it perfectly fine. That seems fine. Let me try another one. Yeah, these are okay. So once you have your perfect dot, erase the other ones, okay? And that's going to be the background of my number sticker. So I'm going to grab my lasso tool, select this that I just created to resize it and make it bigger, somewhere there. And then I'm going to go to my text tool here. I'm gonna tap anywhere to create a text box, and then I like entering a big number, meaning a white number, so not one because that's not very wide. And if I make all my text boxes with the dimensions to fit number one, then it's likely that when I get to the number 20 something or number 30, it's not going to fit on my box. So what I'll do is write number 30 instead, just to make sure that any other number will fit as well. So as you can see, this one is a little bit big right now, so I just select my text by double tapping on it, and then I go to my text size over here and then make this a little bit smaller. Another thing I like doing is centering my text, so go to paragraph and click on center, okay? Just to make sure that all of the boxes will be centered. And one more thing you can try is go back to paragraph and then make this smaller. This slider, move it a little bit to the left just so that you make your text box a little bit smaller, and then you don't have that extra transparent area hanging outside of your sticker so that it's easier to work with. Okay, now I just center my text box, and just like that, you have created a number sticker. So now you've guessed it, you just have to duplicate this, and actually it's quite small, so let me just select all of this. Make sure that under your lasso menu you have everything selected, and then you can create a selection with the lasso, click on resize, drag this ball to make the sticker bigger, somewhere there I think. And now I'm just going to go and then select that, click on copy on the menu that pops up, and then tap and hold on the screen to click on paste. And I'm going to start arranging my stickers. You know, I need a total of 31 of these if I want to date the calendars of my planner. So I'm gonna make rows of 8, all right? So I need two more, copy. And this is just to keep them somewhere, so of course it's okay if they're not aligned. I will copy them all and then paste them under. So you'll have 8, 16, 24, 32. And then I can get rid of the last one because I only need 31, okay? Now I go click on my text box, double tap on a text box here, and add each of the numbers. Now, the number one in this particular font is a little bit too much to the right, so I'm just gonna pull these dots to the left to center it a little bit, okay? Then you just keep going here and would change all of the numbers of these stickers so that you have all of the numbers of the month. Now for this part, I'm just going to speed the video up and show you when I'm done. Now one tip I have for you, when you double tap on a text box, make sure you do it like slowly, because I don't know, I feel like if you do it fast, GoodNotes changes the configuration of the text for some reason, but if you do it slowly, it seems to work fine. So you know, just take your time to double tap slower and you shouldn't have problems. Okay, so here I have my 31 numbers. So let's go and place them on top of an actual calendar. So copy these numbers. I'm gonna go to the month of July. Here it is. And then as you can see, I have my dates already because this planner comes dated. But if I wanna change the style of my numbers, I can still do that using these new stickers. So I just paste them here, and before I deselect them, since they're all selected, I can just resize them together and check what's the size I'm going to want them to be. I just want to be able to cover the existing numbers. Once you have the right size, now you can deselect, and using your lasso tool, I'm going to start placing the stickers on the right spots. Here I need the first four. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and I'm just going to start aligning them so that they can cover the existing numbers. Now, I know this part looks a little bit tedious, but once we're done, I'll show you how easy it will be to use all these numbers and all this effort that you did already to date the following spreads in your planner. It's so quick, you'll see. Okay, I have my last week over here. Okay, so I have redated all of my month here. Now you're gonna see how awesome this is, because you can really quickly and easily edit all of the stickers once you have placed them like this. So go to your lasso menu, and this time you wanna turn off the text box option here. So just turn that off. And now I'm going to select all of my numbers with my lasso tool. So just make a big selection surrounding them all. And then you are going to tap on that selection, go to color, and choose any color that you want. For example, purple. And just like that, I have changed the color of all of my stickers with just a couple of taps. You see, that's so easy. Now, one other thing you can do, let me zoom in so you can see better. You go back to your lasso menu, this time turn on text boxes, but turn off handwriting, because if you recall, the background of our stickers is handwriting. So now make a big selection again. This time you are only selecting your numbers. Tap on your selection, click on color, and now pick another color, and that will change only the color of the numbers. So let me pick something that actually looks good, something like that. And as you can see, now you have a new color combination for your stickers. So as I said, you did all the work once, but you don't have to redo it every time. And the magic is not over. Go back to your lasso menu, this time turn on handwriting again, so make sure you have all of your options turned to on. And then you copy all of these stickers, so make a big selection, tap on your selection, click on copy. Now we're gonna head to a different month, so let's go to August here. Tap on hold, click on paste, and let's see. So obviously these are not aligned the way I need them, but don't panic, here's what I'll do. As you can see, number one is here, so I want to keep all of my numbers that are to the left of my one, okay? So just place them anywhere, okay? Now with your lasso, you are going to select the numbers that are to the right of that number one, and you are going to cut them, okay? So you have them cut, now you will be able to align all these other numbers. So as you can see, here I have my one. I don't know if this is too far, let me zoom in. As you can see, I have the same number, so 5, 5, 12, 12, 1, 1. And now I can align them right on top of where I need them to be. But remember, I have the other number saved, so I'm just gonna tap on the screen, click on paste, and then I'm going to be able to paste the rest of the numbers where they need to go. And just like that, I have changed the dates of another monthly spread. Now, once again, you can go and turn off the options that you need from up here in the lasso menu, and you can go ahead and change the color to something else. Now I'm gonna change the background of the stickers. Now, of course, what I showed you, you can do only in GoodNotes, but you should be able to replicate this method in NoteShelf or Notability or any other note-taking app that allows you to create multiple items and grab them all at the same time using your lasso tool or similar. Now, another thing you can do is if you go back to the original page where we created the numbers, you can copy all of these and paste them right here if you want to have them ready in different colors. So let me turn off my text boxes. Let's say that I want to have them ready in multiple background colors. So I just select the background, and actually let me paste another set over here. Just select them with my lasso, and I can change the color to have them ready to go. This is especially useful if you are using different planners and you just want your own number stickers ready to use. So this is the final result of the stickers that we have created. As you can see, it was really quick. I actually went ahead and uploaded this set that we just created to the Printstick library. So if you open your library and go to the section that says editable stickers, which is on the second page right here, you open that section and you'll see these date stickers. So if you want to download them, you just tap to open, and then at the bottom here you'll see the download available. So from here you would just click on opening GoodNotes or export to GoodNotes and import as a new document, and here you will have the file ready to go. Now just remember that this is using the Racquetbolt font, and if you want the stickers to look the same and not have the default font selected, you have to make sure that you have that font installed to the iPad before opening the file. So I have actually also added that font to the library, and that is located in this brand new font section, and I actually have added a few fonts here already, so Racquetbolt is the one that you need. You can just go ahead, download this, then you have to unzip this file and install it using the free app iFont. I'm gonna link below a video where you can follow the steps on how to install it. Once you have that installed, then you can go ahead and download and install the editable sticker set from the library. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and that you learned something new today, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up to let me know, and if you have any questions or suggestions, feedback, anything you want to share with me, drop me a comment below, I'll get back to you as quick as I can. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet, and click on the bell so you know when there's a new video out. I'm always sharing cool tips and tricks and fun things you can do on your iPad. Thank you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye!